G'day, it's Clayton from Planet Canada. Today, let's tackle an interesting question that I've been asked several times before. How can I add a custom comment to my S2M part labels? The advantage of this is that I could put a custom comment on my labels that says whatever I want. I could, for example, create an attribute that defines the kind of paint color or finish that I have per room or per cabinet, and then link it to my part comment, which is displayed on my label. I'm sure you could also find a lot of advantages to adding this field though. So let's discuss how to set it up and you can personalize it and customize it to whatever suits you. So today let's follow these three instructions here. We're gonna create a room attribute, much like the room attribute you see here, the change toe height, but we're gonna add another field. And then we're going to link this field here to the part comment. So for instance, if I double click on my cabinet and click on an individual part, you'll notice that under properties and then comment, every single part has this comment field. So whatever I type in here, I could link to an S2M label that will display this comment that I've added. But if I wanted to, I could create an attribute on the room level that will automatically fill in this space. So let's close that, click return, and we'll go through this together. So the first thing we want to do is create a room attribute. So we're going to close down this job. We're going to click on utilities and then parameters. And then here we can create this attribute, this room attribute. Let's just put, for the sake of simplicity, let's imagine that we want to add the paint or stain finish to our labels. We could put cabinet finish. This is just a name for your reference in the project as a user. Under parameter, we're going to actually create our own parameter that we can reference in a UCS. So I'm going to put underscore custom comment. I'm going to make this a text field because I'd like the ability to write in text. I could add a comment here, which will be the default for every new room, or we could just leave this blank and fill it in when the time comes. And then underneath class, if I click on room, I can link this attribute to the room level, but you could see I could also link it to the job, the cabinet, or even be more specific if I wanted to. We want to keep it an attribute. So that's the first step done. If I open up a new job and okay, you can see that now I automatically have a room attribute with the cabinet finish. If I add a cabinet now, you'll notice though that just because I have that field there, there's nothing in cabinet vision telling it that the part comment should be identical to that room comment or that cabinet finish comment we've introduced. So this is where we're going to create a UCS. So I'm going to click on utilities, UCS, and if I click on new, I'll get the UCS wizard pop-up. And here we're going to modify our finished, we'll just choose as a finished left end to start, and then we can add more parts in the UCS ourselves. We'll just go comment UCS. Now I know that I'm not going to need to link this to any more specific conditions, but if you wanted to, you could also start defining things like the cabinet class or the object type and so on. But we're just going to click finish now, and you'll see very, very simply, the wizards created this UCS for me, for each left finished part. Then now I can modify the parameter myself. If I wanted to, I could add more part properties, more parts that I want to see this link to. So if I add a divider like that, I could put right finished part. And now for each of my left finished and right finished parts, I can control the comment. If I click on comment now, I'm telling Cabinet Vision that for each of these parts, the comment is going to equal. And now I'm going to use this symbol here so that it doesn't get confused. Custom comment. comment. If I didn't use these symbols here at the start, Cabinet Vision would quite literally put in custom comment in that field, but we actually want it to use what the custom comment is. So that's very simple, but that's all we need for our UCS. If I close that now and it's turned on and click on return. Now, if I click return and go to my room parameters, I could put paint test. Now, theoretically, for my left finished and my right finished part, that comment should be following that field. I'm going to click right click, properties, comment, and automatically it's populated with paint test. That's exactly what we want. That's fantastic. So now, the third step is that we want to make sure our labels are calling on this comment field. So I'm going to go to S2M Center, and then I'm going to optimize these parts so I can get to my S2M label settings. And then I'm going to click on reports. And you can see that on my pick part labels here, there's no field calling on my part list comment. There is, though, on this other label, already the comment set up so that it's adding the paint test automatically. So if you're using a label report which is already set up and configured, but it's just missing this comment field, it's very easy for us to add it. I'm going to click on setup reports, and then you'll notice if I right click and go to properties, and then I click on tables part list, and then I scroll across to the comment field, you'll see that on my left finished end and my, there you go, I can open that up, my finished left end and my finished right end, both of them have the paint test comment that I've added. So to the fact that I can see it there means this is going to work. I can add it in my, if I right click and go edit on the label report, now I can add this field. So let's say I wanted to use this space here. This is a blank space. I can click on variables, part list. This is linking to that table that we just saw. And I can scroll down till I find comment, and then I can click insert. And you can see it's giving me a preview of that information, which means the paint test works. Click okay, okay, save and close. And now when I reload my labels on my finished left end and my finished right end, I should see this paint test comment that we've added. So there you can see, I've got paint test there and there, exactly what we were after. So that means it's worked. If I return to the elevation, I've just got a couple of tips for you which might help you out. Of course, I've used the paint or finish as an example, but really you could put whatever you wanted to in this field and call it whatever you wanted to. But the other thing is, if you're new to UCSs, if I click on UCSs and code, you might be wondering where you can find a list of all of these codes to add in case you want more than just your finished left end and your finished right end being linked. Well, if I click return and file and close, and I go to my part manager, you'll just notice, if I bring that across, here is a list of all of the different codes and what they're being linked to. So if you're wondering what any of the codes are that you could add, you'll find that here in your part manager. Ultimately though, learning how to link attributes and write very basic UCSs can really help you take your Cabinet Vision to the next level. So I hope you found this useful. Let us know if you have any questions, and thank you for listening.
Hey, thanks so much for watching. If you'd like to see more tutorials like this one, please be sure to like and subscribe. You can also check out our other videos that will help guide you on your path to becoming a Cabinet Vision Power User.